Well, guys, in a dramatic turn of events, criminal gangs in Haiti have declared war on Kenyan police, real war. The Kenyan police intervention force that was sent by President William Ruto. As tensions escalate, the situation on the ground is becoming increasingly volatile in Haiti. This video delves into the unfolding conflict, exploring the reasons behind the gang's bold declaration on the potential implications for the Haiti and Kenya, for both Haiti and Kenya. Stay tuned as we unravel this complex and dangerous situation. To understand the current conflict, we need to look at the background of the Haitian gang crisis. Haiti has a long struggle with political instability, economic hardships, and natural disasters like earthquakes, of which have all contributed to the rise of powerful criminal gangs. These gangs control a large portion of the capital, Port-au-Prince, and they are involved in various illegal activities including drug trafficking, kidnapping, extortion, etc. The government's inability to maintain order has allowed these gangs to flourish, leading to widespread violence and fear among the Haitian population. The Kenyan police intervention in Haiti is part of the border of a broader international effort to restore peace and stability in that country. The United Nations and other international bodies have called for assistance to support Haitian government in combating the gangs. Kenya, known for its robust police force and experience in dealing with similar crises, was requested to send a contingent to help stabilize the situation in Haiti. The decision to involve the Kenyan police was based on their reputation, effectiveness, peacekeeping missions, and the ability to operate in a challenging environment. The reaction to the Kenyan police intervention has been mixed. Many Haitian citizens are hopeful that the presence of a strong and disciplined force will help bring to an end the violence and restore sense of security. However, the gangs see this as intervention as a direct threat to their control and responded aggressively. The international community has expressed support for the intervention, but there are concerns about the potential for increased violence and the safety of the Kenyan police force. As the conflict escalates, several potential outcomes and consequences emerge. On one hand, intervention could succeed in dismantling gangs' power structures, leading to a period of stability and recovery to Haiti. On the other hand, the gangs' violent response could result in a prolonged bloody conflict, which will further destabilize the region. The situation also poses a risk for the Kenyan police, as these forces could suffer casualties and face international scrutiny for intervention and does not go as planned. Additionally, the conflict may draw in other international players, complicating the dynamics. The declaration of war by the Haitian gangs against the Kenyan police intervention force marks a critical juncture in Haiti's ongoing crisis. The coming days and weeks will be crucial in determining the future of this conflict and its broader implications. Stay tuned to our channel for more updates and in-depth analysis as we continue to monitor this volatile situation. Do not forget to like this video and subscribe and hit the notification bell to stay informed. So guys, our police from Kenya were sent to Haiti, and immediately they were sent there, the protests in Kenya also broke. The funny thing is that the government of Kenya has been using gangs to quell the riots. They put the gangsters among the... So I think we have failed as a state, And it was very unfortunate for our Kenyan government to send police into Haiti. It was very, very unfortunate situation. And we hope that they will not be casualties in Haiti. We hope they will come back alive. So thank you guys for watching, and you can kindly subscribe to this channel. If it's your first time, just subscribe and like the video. We'll thank you so much, and see you in our next video.